Hello guys, welcome back to Techdose, and in this video we will see how to find the minimum number of platforms needed in a railway station so that no two trains can come on the single platform at the same time. That means no train has to wait. So let us look at the problem statement. Let us say we have been given arrival time as well as departure time of the trains. Okay, so I have written according to the trains, I have taken 6 trains. And we are required to find what is the minimum number of platforms needed in this railway station. So the time is like the last two digits denotes the minutes and the leftmost one depicts the hour. So 9:00 means 9 o'clock. 9:10 means 10 minutes past 9. Okay. 12:00 means 12 o'clock and so on. So this is the timing convention. And this train T1 arrives our station at 9 o'clock and departs at 10 minutes past 9 o'clock. This train 2 comes at 9:40 and departs at 12 and so on. Okay. Now, how do you find the minimum number of platforms needed to serve this schedule? One simple way is to take one interval. Let us say I take this interval T1, this interval. And then what I will do is I will compare with all the remaining intervals, all these remaining intervals, and then see how many are coinciding. That means how many are in intersection. That I will keep it as max number of intersection. Let us say max platform, and the maximum number of intersections will be equals to the maximum platform. So for the first interval, let us say I find that there are 2 intersections, so the maximum platform needed will be 2. Then I will repeat the same thing by taking this interval, the second interval, and then I will repeat this entire thing. Okay, so this will be the brute force method actually, because it will take order of n square time. We are actually fixing one interval and then we are checking, that means iterating through all the other intervals, and then we are finding which one are coinciding with this picked interval, and then we are determining the maximum number of platforms which are needed. Okay, there is one efficient approach. The efficient approach says that we should sort this arrival time as well as departure time in ascending order. So let us say I sort this arrival as well as departure time of the train. You can see that this arrival time is already sorted. So I will just copy it. It is 900, 940, 950, 1100, 1500 and 1800. Now the departure time should also be sorted. It will be 910, 1120, 1130, 12, then 19 and then 20. Okay. So now these two arrays are sorted. Now what is our goal? Our goal is to find what will be the minimum number of platforms present in this current station so that this schedule of train is served. Okay. So how do you find it? We will assume that minimum we need one platform. At least a station should have one platform. Therefore, I will take a variable max platforms and there I will assign value 1. Because at least we need one platform so that one train can pass. I will take two variables, two pointers. Okay. And I will fix J pointer to the departure array's first element and an I pointer to the arrival array second element. Okay. And then what I will do is I will just iterate. Whenever I increase this departure pointer to the right, then I will decrement the maximum number of platforms. Okay. And let us say I take another variable needed platforms. And this is initially 1, because this will be our final result. How many platforms do we need? Now we start iterating. We see which time is lower in the time series order. You can say that 10 past 9 is lower than 9:40. Therefore, I will just increment this departure. Okay. And then what I will do is I will just decrement this max platform needed to 0. Because after 9:10, there will be no train at this station, therefore we don't need any platform. Okay, now you compare with 940 and 1120. You can see that 940 is lower, therefore we will increment this I and we will also increment the maximum platform needed. When we increment this maximum platform, then we will compare maximum platform with the needed platform. If needed platform is lower than maximum platform, then we will update this needed platform. Since they are equal, we will not update this needed platform. Now you can see that 950 is still lower than 1120, so another train has arrived and we will increment this I pointer to its right, and I will increment the maximum platform needed to 2, because there are 2 trains presently at our given station. Now since needed platform is lower than max platform, therefore I will update this needed platform to 2. Now you again see this timing order. You can see that 11 is still lower than 1120. Therefore, there is yet another arrival of a train, okay, before departure of this one. So I will again increment this max platform by 1, which will be 3. And then I will compare needed platform with max platform. So I will update this needed platform to 3. Okay. Now you see that 1120 is lower than 15. Therefore, one of our train will depart. And therefore, I will decrease the maximum platform needed by 1. That means one train has departed. Now, max platform is lower than needed platform. So we don't need to update this needed platform. Okay. Now again, another train will leave our station at 11:30. So I will again update this, since 11:30 is lower than this 15. Okay. And I will decrement the max platform needed to 1. Now again, it's 12 and another train will leave, because 12 is lower than 15. So I will just increment it and I will decrement max platform needed to 0. Okay. So presently at this time, there is no train at our station. Okay. Now you can see that 15 is lower than 19. Therefore, one train will arrive at our station, and so we will increment this pointer and I will increment this max platform to 1. Now 1 is lower than 3. Therefore, we don't need to update this needed platform. Now again, you can see that 18 is lower than this 19. Therefore, another train has arrived. I will increment this pointer and then I will increment the max platform needed. Okay. Now you can see that all the elements in this arrival array have been traversed. Okay. In either of this array, if all the elements are traversed, then we will stop there and we will return the needed platform as the minimum number of platforms which must be present in our given railway station so as to serve this time schedule. Okay. So that no train has to wait. So what will be the time complexity of this solution? The time complexity will be order of n for this traversal. Okay, for this solution, it will be order of n plus n log n for our sorting, because we have sorted this array, this arrival as well as the departure array. So that will take n log n time for sorting. And then if we are given this arrival and departure array as a sorted array, then it will just take order of n time, because we are just traversing through these two arrays. Okay, so the time complexity can be said to be order of n log n. So this is our time complexity. I think this was a very interesting question. If you have any type of doubt regarding why I have sorted this or any other doubt, then please comment below and feel free to ask any question you have. I will try to help you as soon as possible. Like and share our video and subscribe to our channel in order to watch more of these programming videos. See you on our next video. Thank you.